Gunmar must be very much on his way back to see Isran. And I need to find Serene Gerard after I kill this dragon. You see me? Because I most assuredly see you. Coward, you would attack these innocent people of Rorikstead? You must know that there's darker magic here in Rorikstead than you. I have heard the rumors. This dragon seems older and more powerful. Come, meet your fate. I can take out your wings. Perhaps I was a bit too hasty. Oh, thank Auriel. I thought to purchase these potions from Angelique Mirard. Let's work together, guard. We'll flank him. Guard, run! I swear by Auriel, that is the last life you will take. Give my regards to Alduin. Sorry about your guards. If you send word to the local Jarl, I'm sure they'll be replaced.
I don't know if that's such a good idea.
One of you, run and tell the Jarl what happened here today.
Please stay away while you got that spell on you.
That's what you're concerned about? Just took down this ancient dragon for you, and you're concerned about my spell. The people of Skyrim are befuddling, to say the least. I think they need to get their priorities in order. Oh, I swear I heard a growl. Aha! You think these wolves would be more careful with their selection of a lunch? Oh dear. It's too bad the wolf couldn't fight the bandits first. Soften them up for me. Hello? You there behind the rock? And I can shoot you in the face. Sir, you seem to have an arrow through your head. Sir?
No more.
Have another. I do not accept yields anymore. You want more? Are you this eager for death? Ma'am, there's an arrow in your... What magic compels these bandits to keep fighting when... I hit him right in the neck! call me bastard. Now, if I'm reading my notes correctly, Isran told me that Serene Girard should be slightly northwest of here. Or perhaps it's more north. No, it's definitely northwest. Seems to be some sort of a mine.
Whoa there! I don't know where you're going, but stay out of that mine. It isn't safe.
The mine isn't safe? Why?
We tunneled into an old Nordic crypt. The whole place is crawling with Draugr. We're not mining up any ore with those undead around, so I wouldn't go down there if I were you.
Draugr, you say? I'll stay out then.
Good to hear.
Good day. Why in the world would I go into a cave filled with Draugr? A mine, I should say. As if that's any better. But a mine filled with Draugr. If I don't have to. I feel like in the past I've done things like that, just diving headlong into battle. For no reason other than just something to do. What now? I sense Hagraven magic. There's no way that missed. This one shall. No? Oh, they must have some sort of a protective enchantment upon them. Yes, that must be it. Oh. What is blocking my shots? I understand not. Good. You can terrorize the good people of Skyrim, no longer witch. And to think that Hagraven could have been my mother-in-law. Ariel, protect me from that fate. Now, what experiments were you doing on this poor giant and his mammoth? Perhaps the contents of this chest will shed some light on your intent. Illusion and a scroll. Seems as though you've been brewing potions as well. It appears as though your magic had no focus. You were just all over the place. Oh no. Forsworn. World? They must be under the Raven's enchantments. Where did you come from? Oh, at least I was able to thin out their numbers a bit. Yes, my Atronach will soften them up. Perhaps I could flank them from this angle. Not worth it. Stop running around. What is that glowing thing? No matter. I think I shall leave this place. I can just get across this river. This should be Blind Cliff Cave if I'm reading my map correctly. Let's see. If I go this way, it's take me near Carthwaston. I need to go down this road to the northeast and loop back around. I think I've gotten myself quite turned around here. Hello? Is everything all right?
There are dragons about, traveler. Be warned.
It happened so fast. 1 minute the dragon was there, the next it was gone. Everything was destroyed.
A dragon? Did you see which way it went?
No. I was too afraid to look. I don't know what we're going to do now. We have nothing left.
Well, I'm glad to give you some gold.
You're too kind. Thank you. Be careful and stay safe.
I wouldn't worry about me. I'd worry about yourself. And if I was that dragon, I'd be quite worried as well. If I can find him, I think I'll kill him a bit quicker than the one in Rorikstead. That fight got messy. I shouldn't come face to face with the dragon. As strong as I've become here in Skyrim, Well, that's not a fight I can win. If I could find a way to sneak up on the foul beast. I think my chances of success and, well, at the very least not wasting potions is quite a bit higher. What now?
Sell swords out of my mind.
Watch your tongue, native. We'll leave when we're sure there's no force worn here.
Oh, and when would that be, I wonder? Would I sell my land to the Silverbloods?
The Silverbloods have made you a very generous offer for this pile of dirt. I suggest you take it.
You there.
Please stay away while you get
brilliant.
You having trouble with the mine?
Robbery is what it is. The Silverbloods are trying to muscle in on my land. Forsworn attack the mines, and suddenly all these sellswords show up to help. They won't let anyone work until I sell it off.
I can convince them to leave.
You can try, but I'd keep your sword arm ready if things get ugly.
It won't.
Till next time.
Draugr? They'd be on their own, but I'm not going to sit here while sellswords practice extortion. You there!
The mine is closed. Get lost.
Excuse me. I want you and your men to leave.
Helping out Einathatch, huh? Give me a reason not to plunge a dagger in your chest.
Oh, you're a talker. Listening to talkers makes me a little upset. I'll make it simple. If any more words come pouring out your mouth, I think I'll kill you.
Whoa, wait a second. I was just kidding. We'll leave.
Hmm. I suspected as much.
Mm-hmm.
Go in the mine. Get your men out of there now. Now, where was that poor fellow who had to deal with this? I think I saw him go in here.
You lost?
You there.
I'm one of the few native sons of the Reach that owns land. Doesn't make me very popular.
Well, those sellswords won't be a problem anymore.
That won't be the last we hear from the Silverbloods. But at least we can get back to work. Thank you. You've done a good thing for me and my workers. Here, this is for you.
No, you really don't. Well, thank you.
All right, then.
Now I can be on my way. I was in no mood to deal with Draugr earlier. I just didn't have the time, but I knew those sellswords were cowards, and they'd be simple and quick to get rid of. I believe this is where... Yes. There she is. Serene. Serene Girard?
What mud crabs want with my satchel anyway?
What?
You haven't seen a sack full of dwarven gyros lying around, have you?
A sack full of...
I swear I left it right here.
I...
Do you think mud crabs might have taken it? I saw one the other day. Wouldn't be surprised if it followed me here.
Mud crabs?
Well, just look around, will you?
Look, Isran asked me to find you.
Isran? Wants me? No, you must be mistaken. He made it exceedingly clear the last time we spoke that he had no interest in my help.
Hmm.
I find it hard to believe he's changed his mind. He said some very hurtful things to me before I left. Anyway, I'm quite happy in my current pursuits. So if you'll excuse me...
So... You had a falling out with Isran?
Yes, that was my point. I felt it was rather clear. Look, what is it you want from me?
Well, look, vampires threaten all of Skyrim and...
Vampires? Really? Oh, and I suppose now he remembers that I proposed no less than 3 different scenarios that involved vampires overrunning the population. Well, what are they up to?
We don't know what their master plan is. It's difficult to discern, but Isran is concerned.
In case you haven't noticed, Isran is always concerned about something.
That's what got us working together in the first place. Still, if he sent you to find me, it may actually be pretty bad.
I can assure you it is.
All right. If nothing else, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to learn more about what's going on so I can better defend myself. But I'm not just going to abandon what I've been working on here. It's too useful. I need at least one intact Dwarven gyro. So either I need to find the satchel those mud crabs stole, or I need another gyro from someplace. You wouldn't happen to have one, would you?
Not on me. Look, Serene, there's no time. We need to get moving now.
Fine, fine. I can't afford to forget about this work, though. Some very interesting applications.
I'm sure.
Now, where is it I'm supposed to be going?
Well, we're meeting at Fort Dawnguard near Riften.
Ah, been working more on his secret hideout, has he?
Yes.
It'll be interesting to see how much progress he's made.
I think quite a bit.
I'll finish up here and head in that direction as soon as I can. See you there.
All right. Thank you again.
Farewell. I guess I'll see you at Fort Dawnguard.
Absolutely. Strange he has such a vested interest in the Dwemer. I feel she could probably learn quite a bit from me. I've spent enough time in their ruins. Oh, I'm sure she'd be very fascinated to see my ethereal crown. I bet she's never seen the like of it. I doubt anyone in Tamriel alive today has ever seen the like of it. So with Gunmar and Serene on the way back to Dawnguard, I suppose I should make my way there as well. And see what Isran has planned next for us. I suppose it's only a matter of time until... I think I just heard something. Must have just been distracted with how immersive these grasses are. They're very, very nice. The way they move in the wind. Reminds me of grasses we have along the beaches in Skywatch. They grow right along the sand. Trying to recall if I've been here before. Oh, what happened to this poor fellow? Is that a dragon? Sleeping right there? I should tread carefully. Not a very powerful dragon, were you? Your power is mine. This means grace in the common tongue. Thought before that, Perhaps it's only a matter of time until I'm chosen to lead this Dawn Guard. I rather don't think I'd accept. Much like the Legion, I'll do my work and then move on. I have other things to do here in Skyrim. I don't want to waste away in this fort. Hello? You mind if I open the gate? I'll just... Don't worry about it. Alright. I suppose I'll close it as well. Yes. Wouldn't want you to get up. Just stay where you are. Oh, it's difficult to make your way here at night. Even though the path is lit well enough. No guards at the gate. Ah, they beat me here. What is this? Isran?
All right, Isran. You've got us all here. Now what do you want?
Hold it right there.
What are you doing?
Making sure you're not vampires. Can't be too careful.
You certainly can't.
So welcome to Fort Dawnguard. I'm sure you've heard a bit of what we're up against. Powerful vampires, unlike anything you've seen before. And they have an Elder Scroll. If anyone is going to stand in their way, it's going to be us.
This is all well and good, but do we actually know anything about what they're doing?
We'll get to that. For now, get acquainted with the space. Sorin, you'll find room to start your tinkering on that crossbow design. Gunmar. There's an area large enough for you to pen up some trope. Get them armored up and ready for use. In the meantime, we're going to get to the bottom of why a vampire showed up here looking for you.
For me?
Let's go have a little chat.
Oh dear. A vampire? Here looking for me? Well, that can't be good.
Florentius really talks to R.K.?
I'm not sure. I've never heard of the Divine speaking directly to someone before.
So you think he's just crazy?
I didn't say that. I wondered if perhaps he did it for the attention. But every now and then he'll say something that makes me reconsider.
I suppose we're all a little crazy to be here, right?
Serena, is there something wrong with your neck?
Cozy
well,
little
this
place.
Isn't exactly a palace, is it? Still, it's sturdy, secure, and seems defensible.
It certainly is defensible.
I suppose I'd rather be here than most other places in Skyrim.
Solitude's nice.
Isran needs me. Must be pretty bad. I wonder what we're up against here.
Well, I've seen some of it. There's a master vampire holed up in a castle just northwest of Solitude, but while you're here... Do you know much about archery?
You're already as good as I am. There's nothing you can learn from me.
Well, thank you for the compliment. While you're settling in, what do you know of the old Dawn Guard?
I've only heard stories. Not sure if any of them are true. Like that they were supposed to guard some vampire here, but wound up all becoming vampires themselves when they saw how powerful he was. And then preyed on the rift until finally someone put them down. Guess it doesn't matter now. At least Isran is trying to do something noble with the name.
Yes, indeed. He does seem quite dedicated to the cause. Listen, I was given a crossbow, but do you know how to make a better one?
A basic one? Of course. That is, assuming you know anything about steelsmithing. It's pretty simple. Talk to Gunmar if you need materials.
I'll do that. Speaking of materials, Serene, do you trade? I mean, do you have anything for sale?
It's not easy to get supplies way out here, but I'm managing. Take a look.
Thank you. I'm actually more in the way of selling some things. I need some gold. Well, I don't need gold, I just like it. Maybe you can make use of these robes. And, let's see. Do you have any call for scrolls? Probably not. Here, take this staff at a discount. Thank you, Serene. I appreciate it. Even though you know he's around from before, I know you're just settling in. Can I help you in any way?
I want to add some punch to our crossbow capabilities. I've done all I can on my own. I need a little inspiration. I've always been fascinated with Dwemer artifacts. I take them apart, poke around in their guts, and try to figure things out. Mixed results. But as luck would have it, I've tracked down the location of some actual Dwemer diagram drawings.
I see.
So, if you'd be a dear and collect those plans for me?
Of course, I'm quite comfortable in Dwemer ruins.
See you.
Be well, Serene. While I'm here, I should probably check in on Gunmar, see how he's settling in.
Hope you're getting along with Isran. It takes some getting used to.
So far. Gunmar, is it? Oh.
Yeah?
Pardon me. Do you need any help?
Zareen needs help with her project to improve our crossbows. And if that doesn't interest you, speak with Gunmar. He has something for you.
Of course. I
May
was
your
just
blades
looking for Gunmar.
Stay sharp.
Gunmar. Wake up, friend. You just got here. I know you're weary from fighting bears and from the road, but...
Here we are. It begins again. I fear for what is to come.
As do I. Serene indicated you might be able to train me in smithing.
Working metal isn't easy. Let me show you a few things.
See, I usually hold the hammer like this, and I... Oh, I see. Do you have anything to trade?
Isran had a surprising stockpile of weapons and armor. Take a look.
Let's see. I should be able to unload some of my gear, but... Oh, he had some... quite a collection of Dawnguard armor and... Oh my, is this ebony armor? Very beautiful. I haven't worked with ebony much. It's a beautiful bow. Glacial crystal ingot. You have some rare items here, Gunmar. You certainly do. I wonder if you could make use of this, Well, let's see what I have that you might like. This is a rather powerful warhammer. Perhaps you or one of the other soldiers could put it to use. Now, the orc over there tells me you need a hand with something.
I've located the whereabouts of a vampire masquerading as a common citizen.
Yes.
Track him down, dispose of him. Tread lightly. The law is unaware of the danger and will treat you as a criminal if you're caught.
I see. What is this vampire doing?
Vampires enjoy stalking their prey. Passing among us undetected emboldens them, makes them feel powerful, untouchable. But we'll put a swift end to that.
No point in forming the Jarl. Understood, Gunmar.
The light be with you.
And with you. I suppose I should scurry up the stairs and meet with Isran. Isran, are you... Oh, I'll be right up. Let's see if I can... here's the stairs. Isran. What's this about a vampire here to see me? Isran? Isran, what is the...
So let's hear it.
Serana. By Ari El, what is she doing here? Isran probably thinks I'm a traitor, but he's invited her in. I should... Serana?
You probably weren't expecting to see me again.
Certainly not, and you look... You look so different.
probably weren't expecting to see me again.
No, what are you doing here?
I'd rather not be here either, but I needed to talk to you. It's important, so please just listen.
To me?
Before your friend here loses his patience. It's... well, it's about me, and the Elder Scroll that was buried with me.
I can't imagine Isran's reaction when you knocked on the door. What about the scroll, but... no, more importantly, what about you?
The reason I was down there, and why I had the Elder Scroll. It all comes back to my father. I'm guessing you figured this part out already, but my father's not exactly a good person.
No.
Even by vampire standards. He wasn't always like that, though. There was... a turn. He stumbled onto this obscure prophecy and just kind of lost himself in it.
A prophecy? What sort of prophecy?
It's pointless and vague, like all prophecies. The part he latched onto said that vampires would no longer need to fear the sun. That's what he's after. He wants to control the sun. Have vampires control the world.
Control the
anyway,
sun?
Anyway, my mother and I didn't feel like inviting a war with all of Tamriel, so we tried to stop him. That's why I was sealed away with the scroll.
I see. Serana, you took a big risk coming here.
I did. But something about you makes me think I can trust you. I hope I'm not wrong.
No, you're right. We just have to convince the others that you're on our side.
Well, let's move then. I'm nothing if not persuasive.
That must be true if Isran lets you in. All right, Serana. I'm sure we can get this done if we work together. Isran, what say you?
All right, you've heard what it has to say.
It.
Now tell me. Is there any reason I shouldn't kill this blood-sucking fool right now?
Well, besides the fact that she risked her life even coming here, I need you to set your hatred aside and try to see the larger picture here.
Set my hatred aside? Not a chance. It's what keeps me strong.
You don't trust her. Fine. Trust me. I believe her.
You better know what you're doing. It can stay for now, but if it so much as lays a finger on anyone here, I'll hold you responsible. Got it. You hear me? Don't feel like a guest, because you're not. You're a resource. You're an asset. In the meantime, don't make me regret my sudden outburst of tolerance and generosity. Because if you do, your friend here is going to pay for it.
Thank you for your kindness. I'll remember it the next time I'm feeling hungry. So, in case you didn't notice the giant thing on my back, I have the Elder Scroll with me.
I did.
Whatever it says, it will have something that can help us stop my father. But, of course, neither of us can read it.
Right. So, who can?
Well, the Moth Priests are the only ones I've heard of who can do it. They spend years preparing before they start reading, though. Not that it helps us anyway, because they're all half a continent away. In Cyrodiil.
Some Imperial Scholar arrived in Skyrim a few days ago. I was staking out the road when I saw him pass by. Maybe that's where he's priest.
Do you know where he's staying now?
No. And I'm not going to waste men looking. We're fighting a war against your kind. And I intend to win it. You want to find him? Try talking to anyone who'd meet a traveler. Innkeepers and carriage drivers in the big cities, maybe. But you're on your own.
Any idea how you're going to find a Moth Priest? Skyrim's a pretty big place.
I've only ever known of Moth Priests residing in the White Gold Tower. Where would they go in Skyrim?
Well, back before I... you know. The College of Winterhold was the first place I'd think to go for any kind of magic or historical thing. The wizards know about all kinds of things that people probably shouldn't know about. Actually, now that I think of it, I'm going to come along with you. I've been really wanting to get out and explore a bit.
Believe it or not, but you stand before the Archmage of the College of Winterhold, so you're most welcome to accompany me there. In the meantime, though, what do you know about Elder Scrolls?
I mean, as much as anyone. Not a lot. You'd figure a couple hundred years locked away with one would have given me some insight, but no. Turns out you don't learn much from just sleeping with something.
I'm not sure I completely agree with that. Are you saying you want to learn more about me?
Not at this rate, no.
Were you always a vampire, Serana?
That's A long story.
Please, I want to hear it.
I guess we kind of have to go way back, to the very beginning. Do you know where vampirism came from?
I believe the first one was created by a Daedric lord, was it Molag Bal?
Exactly. The first vampire came from Molag Bal. She was not a willing subject, but she was still the first. Molag Bal is a powerful Daedric lord, and his will is made reality. For those willing to subjugate themselves, he will still bestow the gift, but they must be powerful in their own right before earning his trust.
I see. So how did you actually become a vampire, then?
The ceremony was degrading. Let's not revisit that. But we all took part in it. Not really wholesome family activity, but I guess it's something you do when you give yourselves to a Daedric lord.
I see. Yes, we needn't talk about that. If you forgive me, though, how has it affected your family?
Well, you've met most of us. My father's not exactly the most stable, and eventually he drove my mother crazy with him. And it all ended with me being locked underground for who knows how long.
Oh, Serana.
It's definitely been a bad thing, on the whole.
Serana, I'm so sorry. Are you all right?
I will be. Just give me a little time.
Of course. I'm glad to have you as a companion. You can follow me to the college and perhaps we can talk more along the way. You've been through so much, you poor thing. I have to remind myself that you're centuries older than I. So, Serana? Yes. We'll make the way to my college. It's high time that I checked in anyway. It's been quite a while since the Archmage has set foot through the gates. I'm sure Tolfdir especially will be glad of my help. I remember how much poor Mirabelle did for Savos. I suppose he too was always off on adventures and doing research. He wasn't much concerned with the day-to-day operation of the college, was he? So perhaps I should not feel so guilty that I'm not there more often. The fact of the matter is that as much as I've learned, my true interests really don't lie with magic. I truly see magic as just a tool, a means to an end. Not a pursuit unto itself, as perhaps I should. Let's see, on the way to the college, I wonder if I could help Mirabelle. Of course, I mean, Serene Gerard. I can't get Mirabelle out of my head now. What happened to that poor woman? She did not deserve to die that way. But I can help the living. And Gunmar and Serene have both asked for my help. And with Serana, perhaps we can get these errands done a bit quicker. And perhaps for the first time here in Skyrim, for me, the road won't be so lonely. So I could stop in Windhelm and deal with this traveling bard on the way to the college, yes. That makes sense. I'll head to Windhelm.